My name is Cameron Kennedy Douglas. But at camp, I'm known as Songbird. And standing next to me is my brother.
Hello, my name is Gabriel Miguel Douglas, and my nickname is Pentatonix!
Pentatonix and I have both experienced camp as campers. It was really life-changing for us. This next very special guest also has a history with camp. And this past summer, she and I had the privilege of being counselors, co-counselors. And although we approach things very differently, I, as an ex-camper, and she as the CEO of Ronald McDonald House, together we facilitated, we hope, some incredible experiences for our campers. And since our time together this summer, she, Pentatonix, and I have continued to spread the good word about camp and its positive impact. Most recently, we spoke on KTLA 5. She is really a passionate leader, a great co-counselor, and I have to say, a fantastic dancer. So please help me in welcoming to the stage Fatima Rodriguez, the CEO of Ronald McDonald House Charities of Southern California.
Good evening, everyone. Y'all look beautiful, and your dance moves are on point, so thank you for joining in the fun. I first want to thank Songbird. He was such an amazing co-counselor, and our campers absolutely fell in love with him. It was both our first time being counselors at camp this summer, and we were nervous, but we got through it, and we had an awesome time, so thank you, Songbird. As Songbird mentioned, my name is Fatima Jolene Rodriguez, and I'm the CEO for Ronald McDonald House Charities of Southern California. We represent the largest chapter in North America. We have 7 houses throughout Southern California, Camp Ronald McDonald for Good Times, and 3 family rooms. So our reach is vast. But within Southern California, we're also part of a global organization. Ronald McDonald House Charities exists in 62 countries across the world. And I just learned when we were in Chicago for our 50th anniversary that we serve more people than any other nonprofit in the world. So that's incredible impact. Bringing it back to Camp Ronald McDonald for Good Times, I've been with the organization almost 12 years, and 9 of those years was with camp. And this summer was, as I said, my first time as a camp counselor. And it was an incredible experience. If you ask any of our counselors or campers that are here tonight what makes camp so special, you'll often hear it's hard to articulate the magic of camp. That's most of what folks say. So as I was thinking about, well, what am I going to say about camp? And I was scrolling on Instagram today, and lo and behold, Father Greg Boyle pops up into my feed. I don't know if you guys know Father Greg, but he's the director of Homeboy Industries and just a phenomenal leader. And he was promoting his new book, which is called Cherish Belonging. And he was talking about how his editor said, we should just call the book Belonging. And he said, no, because the most important part of the title is Cherish. Because Cherish is all about a deep loving. He says it's a type of loving that rolls up its sleeves. And when he explained that, he talks about how that type of cherished loving creates the real change that we're looking for in the world. Because you can't change systems and you can't change the world until you change individuals. And individuals cannot be changed until they feel seen, loved, and cherished. And that's the experience at Camp Ronald McDonald for Good Times. Our children impacted by cancer, it doesn't just affect the patient, it affects the entire family, it affects siblings, it affects the parents, it affects the community of people. And so it's really, really unique to have a place where our families can go and they don't feel isolated anymore. They're no longer alone, they're no longer othered, they're seen and they're cherished. And that's not only true of our campers, that's true of the counselors, that's true of the staff. Today we're honoring Chad Edwards. They come back because of that belonging and that sense of being whole and being returned to themselves. And so that's why you're here tonight. You're here to celebrate these amazing individuals, but also to be part of the Camp Ronald McDonald for Good Times family. Because every single one of you here is also cherished. And we're so grateful that you're here with us tonight and that you're part of our community. Now I have the great honor of calling up our new executive director, Kevin Garrity. He's been with us for a short time, but in that time of getting to know Kevin, I've really come to appreciate his very calm and just his demeanor of kindness, of really being compassionate, of really wanting to get to know the staff, the community, really understand the mission so he can lead from the mission. And I'm fully confident that this is the leader who is going to take camp to the next level. I'm so excited to welcome Camp Garrity.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Kevin Garrity, and I am incredibly excited and honored to be standing here tonight as your new executive director. Since I started this position 3 months ago, I routinely heard about the magic of camp, the wonders and beauty of the campsite, the amazing and resilient people on our staff and volunteer for us and are so generously supportive of our work. And I'm proud and I'm humbled and excited to share that not only have I felt all of those things, but I have seen firsthand the unique and impactful way, and yes, magical way, that camp positively impacts all of those that are associated with it. So thank you so much. And so I have a bunch of other thank yous to get to, but I really do want to thank each and every one of you for welcoming me into this family. I cannot wait to continue building on the already amazing foundation that is Camp Ronald McDonald for Good Times. Thank you so much. It really means a lot to me. Thank you so much. This is and will continue to be an incredible evening, due in large part to our wonderful sponsors for the evening. And so I want to shout them out. Thank you to Don Francisco Coffee and all of our wonderful table and friend of camp sponsors. Thank you to our bronze sponsors, Bel Air Investments, Kavita and Al Gupta, King and Spalding, David Willingham and Conway, our camp counselors, Moose and Fun. Thank you so much. And thank you to our silver sponsor, Dan and Susan Kane. And to our top sponsor, Living Spaces. We are so grateful for the continued support. All of your generosity allows us to continue providing life-changing experiences for children and families that we serve. Let's give them all one more big round of applause. I also want to extend a heartfelt thank you to our wonderful board of directors. Their partnership, generosity, and support over this past 3 months has been so much to me. It's been such a pleasure working with such a passionate and committed group of individuals. So can I please have all of the board members please stand so we can recognize you all? Misa, and she is here to help recognize, again, Chad Edwards as we celebrate his 20 incredible years at camp.
Misa, please join me in welcoming Misa to the stage.
When new families arrive to camp, Chad is often the first people to greet them, answer the questions, give a tour, and let them know what to expect. For first-time campers, Chad will give their parents a call on the first or second night just to let them know how their child is doing. In other words, Chad is the voice families have learned to trust and associate with camp. A volunteer and former camper said, "Chad was, and still is, exactly who I want to be when I grow up. As a camper, I always wanted him to say my name. When I transitioned to volunteering, I remember going through training and realizing how much thought and intention went into the experience that I and thousands of others had. My respect for Chad has skyrocketed, understanding that I didn't just look up to the cool guy, but I was looking up to one of the best guys I've ever been around. As a colleague, Chad embodies everything you'd want. He's competent, he's resourceful, approachable, and always mission-focused. He has been a rock for us," one coworker said. Over these 20 years, Chad's personal life has grown. He ended up marrying that freckled new volunteer, and they have two children and camp icons, Josie and Owen. Over the years, Chad has faced more than his fair share of challenges. Our camp lost Brian, and Chad lost a mentor and a friend. We know Brian's hiking boots will never be filled, But Brian would be the first one to say they were never his alone, and that camp is and always will be for our camp families. Through his grief, Chet quietly stepped up and took on the role of camp director. Despite everything, he has shown resilience, humility, and strength. He's continued to be a steady and dependable person, balancing his personal and professional lives with incredible dedication to both. He has taught us that no matter how tough the times get, sometimes all you can do for your anyone, even the love of your life, is just make them a cup of coffee and just be there. Chad doesn't survive difficult times, he grows through them. He finds the lesson and manages to come out of it, albeit with a few more gray hairs in his beard, even stronger. But that is who he is, always learning, always evolving, and showing up for those around him. Please enjoy this tribute to our friend Chad.
Daddy started working at camp in 2005, and that is where he met my mommy.
Listen close as I am to you. Like the bell of liberty, I'll ring a sound that's true. And days go by, and seasons too. In time, our love may digress with the words we can renew. Oh, I tell you that I love you by and by. And I don't know if I'd survive without a friend like you in my life.
My daddy loves his job because he makes everybody feel happy.
This web we weave holds us hand in hand. And if we loosen our grips, we may weaken these strands. So let's reinforce our love and let it echo through the land. And if we don't, we may find ourselves washed up with the sand. I tell you that I love you by and by. I don't know if I'd survive without a friend like you in my life. I tell you that I love you by. Without a friend like you in my life.
Congratulations, Daddy, for working at camp 20 years. I'm so proud of what you do for the families. I love you!
Until it finds you. And I'm thankful camp found me. And like Lisa said, it found me in the most random place. You know, the deeper dive into that is that it was a couple of months after 9/11, and I was sitting in the desert of New Mexico, posing as a terrorist group, looking for vulnerabilities in the U.S. satellite system, when I was told about camp. The most random place, in the darkest time, brought this light. And I said, I had to try it. And Lisa told you the story about this, where it went from that. And after that first volunteer session, I realized what I was missing in life. I was missing a community. And I found this camp community, the people in this room, a group of like-minded but highly unique individuals dedicated to a common cause, a great cause, of lifting families who've been devastated by cancer and doing it with their whole heart. And I didn't know what I was going to do when I left that job, and I knew I had to do something like camp. I knew that was the path I wanted to be on, and I didn't know how. So I kept volunteering. And then fortune of the universe decided to shine on me and offer me this opportunity. And like Misa told you, I couldn't say no. So I took a leap, and I came out here, and it was the best decision I've ever made. I'm privileged, I know, that I get to do this for a job. I get to serve the most amazing humans in the world and our families and kids. These are the best people you ever meet. Some in this room. And then I get to see these kids grow up in camp, and many of which come back as volunteers. There's a lot in the room. Give me a shout if you're a former camper. Oh my God. Look at that. Back table to the back. Make sure you talk to those former campers. Best people you ever meet in your life. And what a gift that that's what I get to do. I'm so thankful for everything camp has brought me. And camp has been the most impactful thing in my entire life. As Misa told you, I met my wife at camp. We got married at camp. We had our first child, Josie, in the middle of a summer camp session. That was wild, let me tell you. But she was up, we brought her up to camp that summer, I believe. So her first thing she did was go to camp. I've met my best friends in the world at camp. Camp's made me who I am today. I had the privilege of working with Brian for 18 and a half years. Best 18 and a half years ever. I'm just so thankful for what he did for me and for everyone here. It's just been a gift, and I just can't say that enough. You know, it's been a year of twists and turns. It's been a few years of twists and turns and ups and downs and the path along the way. And no matter the changes that came with camp, no matter those twists and turns, no matter who was here, who wasn't here, there was one group that was always here. And that's that group who was here from the beginning. Those volunteers, those supporters, like people in this room. We come and go, but you haven't. So we faced difficult times, but you kept us afloat. You are our buoys. And I don't think a lot of you realize that. That we've had some tough times at camp, but you kept us lifted. And we can never begin to thank you enough. And this past year, you know, the path that we've been on as a family, you know, had a big curveball thrown our way. A big one in our life. And the first group that stepped up was the care community. It lifted my family so high and kept us so supportive that we couldn't be where we are right now without our camp community. So 20 years is a blink of an eye in the grand scheme. It has meant so much to me and my family that I could never begin to describe. And I could spend another 20 years trying to say thank you to this community, these volunteers, our supporters, our kids, volunteers, the most amazing human beings this world offers. And I could spend another 20 years trying to say thank you, and it would not capture how I truly feel. But I sure as hell would like to try. So my hope is to be here for another 20. And for tonight, this is just beautiful. Thank you all. I love you all. Have a wonderful evening.
few moments to share a little bit about our camp experience with you. Lily actually introduced me to camp, so I'm gonna let her go first.
Hi everyone. Camp has been a huge part of my life over the last 20 years. In 2004, my family began its journey down the roadmap of cancer. My older brother, Drake, kept getting more and more sick until tests finally gave us a lymphoma diagnosis. I was just 8. I just lost my first grandparent, and I was unsure of anything going on. We spent a lot of time in hospitals. Drake lost all his hair and was very sick. It was all so scary at such a young age. Everything had changed. We were in the family of cancer. Everything was focused on how to get Drake better. Luckily, we had a great community to help support us, to care for my younger brother and I, to help my parents in any way possible. But our world was completely different. Through Drake's treatment, his nurse practitioner at City of Hope insisted that he go to summer camp. My parents were very protective and scared to send him away at such a fragile time. But they took the lead and sent Drake and I to Camp Ronald McDonald for the first time. And it changed our lives. Suddenly, we were not a kid with cancer and their sibling. We were just kids. Everyone was there on their own roadmap. So there's an understanding and a support that's unparalleled. On top of that, Drake was able to safely do a lot of things he hadn't in a while. He can go in the pool, he could run in the field, he could play with horses, he could climb the tower, he could play baseball, play basketball. Everyone was so warm, welcoming, genuine, and silly. It was the happiest and most relaxed either of us had been in a long time. So we continued to return, year after year, to feel that sense of belonging, support, and love. Over the years, I remember coming home and trying to explain camp to my parents, family, and friends. It's an extremely hard task now at 30, let alone when I was so young. I would explain all the activities, I'd show the cabin, the little camp photos, I'd point out my new friends and counselors I admired. But the safe, supportive, loving, understanding community that is fostered was more than I even understood myself. Growing up at camp each summer was incredible. It provided me a safe space to be myself, to try new things, to make new friends, to gain confidence and bravery, and become a leader. I got to try different nicknames every year. I got to pretend to break dance for a summer. If only I stuck with it, I could have been in the Olympics this year. I got to be creative, crafty. I got to learn the importance of supporting others and cheering them to do their best. I learned that we're all different, but we're all connected. I learned to respect and support everyone. On top of what camp did for me, I got to watch my older brother open up, sing camp songs, dance, lead a song group at campfire, put on skits, and grow in confidence. He made incredible friends, and he became who he is today. When my younger brother, Neil, was finally old enough to join us, I was so excited for him to be a part of this community. I wanted him to know the support and love I had over the last 5 years. I saw him, anytime I saw him at camp, I would run over to check on him, even if it wasn't in the direction of my next activity. It got to the point where his counselor, Gummy, politely had to tell me to let him have his own experience, and only ask him about it at meal times instead of 20 times a day. Neil did have an amazing experience, and I do have to admit that Gummy was right. I got to join Drake and Wolf for his graduation year. It was an absolutely incredible year. All three of us were at camp. Drake and I did the Wolf hike together. We got to hug Neil covered in mud, and I got to be at Drake's graduation camp with her. I mostly remember crying in a whole night as everyone shared their experiences, their stories, and how much we all loved each other. It was obvious that camp had left its mark on Drake as he was preparing for college. 3 years later, I was sitting around the same campfire pit with my own incredible group of graduates. I was crying just as hard as we exchanged phone numbers and swore we would be back. It took me 4 years, but in 2017, I brought this son to interview to be a counselor, and camp came back into my life.
Woo! Lily and I met when we were 19 in our first year of college, met through some mutual friends, and as we started spending more time with each other, I remember just being drawn to her raw confidence. Lily has this energy that's, she steps in the room and it's, I am Lily freaking Meir, hear me roar. And myself at 19 didn't know how to feel that about myself. And I later found out that that's called positive self-identity. And Lily helped coach me through that, you know, in our first couple of years of friendship and dating. And then in 2017, right after we had graduated college, and she brought me back to, or she brought me to camp to be a counselor for the first time. And we did separate sessions that first summer. I was session two, she was session three. And I just remember being terrified. I was driving up to camp by myself, fresh out of college, had no idea how to take care of myself, let alone 8 to 12 other kids for 5 days. But I drove up and I dropped my stuff off, and I remember standing around kind of awkwardly wondering what to do, and someone walked up to me and shook my hand and said, hey, I'm Rainbow, nice to meet you. And hey, I'm Shannon, welcome, we're so happy to have you here. Hey, I'm Brian, welcome, let me show you around camp. And it was like when you meet someone's family, you can tell that they're all related. All of these people that I was meeting were radiating that same sort of positive self-identity and self-confidence that Lily had taught me to feel. And then as we were sitting down through the training and learning about how intentional everything is at camp and how to describe, label, praise at every opportunity and be intentional with what we're saying and how to create an environment where these kids could be kids and also the best versions of themselves. It was like kind of looking at a textbook of how camp had influenced Lily and her siblings and her family. I had seen all of those things in action down the mountain from them, from the mirrors, before I'd ever actually gone out to be a counselor. And it was just really evident how camp is here to create a space for kids to play and be kids, but also to be incredible human beings and to bring that down the mountain.
Woo!
We got to go back and be summer camp counselors again this past summer. It had been the first time in a couple of years that we were both up the mountain. And our theme of session two was resilience. We had a lot of challenges that we had to overcome. Shout out to Camp Cabin Joseph. I thought it was an excellent metaphor for how camp has been the last couple of years. We've had a lot of challenges. We had COVID, and we did our best to do the virtual camp, virtual programming, and keep the community engaged. And then we thought we were going to come back, and we decided, you know, it was best for us and for the kids and for our community to wait another year. And then we lost Brian, and we're still trying to figure out, I think, how to carry on without him. And this summer was our first time up without Brian, and it was strange to think of the little things that he had taught me in my first session up, like the color chartreuse. And he was the first one to show me around the facilities and to teach me a lot of those camp traditions. But his presence, I think, was still there, and the community was still there, and we all still radiated that energy just the way that Brian taught us. And it was beautiful. It was good to be back. I am very grateful to Lily and the Mirrors for introducing me to this community, and I think that we are all very, very grateful to be here tonight and to be honored with Brian's name. So thank you very much.
This award was established in his memory
to recognize individuals who embody Brian. Brian's dedication, his compassion, and his unwavering commitment to our camp families. Recipients of this award continue Brian's legacy by making a lasting difference and a lasting impact in the lives of children with families with cancer through their extraordinary service and dedication. Brian always talked about how camp isn't a place. That camp is in a parking lot or in a backyard, both of which were true for us in our history. That camp isn't this place, but it's the people. And that camp could happen anywhere. The Mears know firsthand the impact of camp in their lives. And it's my absolute honor and privilege to be able to offer and to award them with the Brian Krager Legacy Award tonight for their unwavering, their extraordinary commitment to camp and to our campers. Thank you for honoring him today, tomorrow, and always. To the Mears.
Many more years of support into Brian's legacy. Thank you.